Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create a surreal, trippy, multi-directional portrait from a face photographed in profile and the same face photographed facing forward. For illustration purposes, I provided this face facing forward and in profile so you can follow along. Because they're not for redistribution, I embedded watermarks on them, but you can apply the techniques that I'll be showing you to your own photos. The first step is to make a selection around your subject so we can isolate the face from the background. There are many ways to make selections, but for this example, I'll use the Quick Selection tool. I'll use a size of 9 pixels and drag over the subject until our face is completely selected. At the top, click the Refine Edge button, or you can go to Select and Refine Edge. I did an in-depth tutorial on Refine Edge, so to save time, I won't be going over all the details here. Check Smart Radius and increase the radius a little. Brush over the hair and output it as a new layer with Layer Mask. Then click OK. Notice in the Layers panel, you now have a new layer with a layer mask of the selection next to it. Open the file of the subject facing forward. Make a selection around the subject, refine its edge, and brush over the hair. This time, save it as a new layer. Make the bottom layer visible and active. We'll fill it with white. First, make sure your foreground and background colors are black and white respectively. If they aren't, press D on your keyboard. Since the background color is white, press Ctrl or Command plus Delete. Open back up your subject's profile. We need to place it into the Face Forward document. Press V to open your Move tool and drag the image onto the Profiles tab. Without releasing your mouse or pen, press and hold Shift as you drag it down onto the image and release. Pressing Shift kept the document centered. Drag the top layer below the middle layer and drag the layer mask next to the middle layer. Temporarily hide the top layer by clicking off the eyeball next to it. Click off the chain link between the middle layer and the layer mask. This will allow us to move and resize the layer and/or the layer mask independently of each other. Click the layer to make it active. To resize and position the face so the lips are synced up with the lips of the profile, open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. First, go inside the Transform and drag your image so the lips are aligned with the lips on the profile. To enlarge the face, go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Shift as you drag the corner out. When the face is sized and aligned to its profile counterpart, press Enter or Return. Next, we'll replace the face forward nose with the nose from the profile. If you look at it long enough, this creates a mind-bending optical illusion that melds two different perspectives of the same face. Make the profile visible and active. Click the layer mask icon to make a layer mask next to the profile. Invert the layer mask by pressing Ctrl or Command I. Invert your foreground and background colors by pressing X on your keyboard. Open your brush tool and open your brush picker. I'll make the size 90 pixels. The hardness is 0% and the opacity and flow are both 100%. Brush over the area to reveal the profile nose. To mask out areas, press X to place black on your brush, and before you start brushing again, make your brush smaller by pressing the left bracket key on your keyboard. Thank you. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.